I'm inviting people. I'm exhausted. But, you know, sometimes you just gotta keep on moving. You gotta keep on moving. Gotta keep working. Alright, I think I've invited enough people. I don't like inviting people. Okay. Probably not gonna stay cute like a kitty. I'm still looking up charts. Literally just got out of the bath. And hello to all those replay viewers. Charts ready. How's everyone doing? Okay, so... Sorry guys, I'm not prepared. Because my brain's not working today. See, this is automatic makeup. Great. Hello, how's it going? I'm just preparing the charts and letting people kind of come on as they wish. I'll be talking about the energy soon. I've been thinking about you, about us. And we're moving slow. My heart's beating. I found it. Okay. I'm gonna turn this music down. Ooh. All right. Okay. Can you give me a thumbs up or a heart if you can hear me? And if you can still kind of hear the music, or is, should I turn off the music? Is it annoying? Okay. I really love the music. What I'll do is I'll pause it. Okay. So, how are you guys doing out there? I've been completely out of it today. Super tired. Which could be due to the, it's called a holiday hangover. So, we had so much going on for Christmas and New Year's. Now we have a holiday hangover. We're tired, but that's not the only reason, because I was a good girl and I did like detoxing yesterday. I just did one job today and relaxed, but I really felt like my body was ahead of my brain. All right, maybe I should take the kitty meow meow off. Because it's annoying. Okay. There we go. Okay. So, what is going on for today astrologically? Uranus just went stationary and it's going direct. It started to go retrograde in on August 3rd. August 2nd, August 3rd of last year. So it's been in retrograde for a while, which is pretty much rethinking, organizing, everything about the future, right? And Uranus is the future. It's also systems, how our government works. So that's probably why there's been a lot of different changes. And stuff like, sorry guys, a lot of changes and stuff like that, to the way that we see, not only our future, but the way that our system is run, how, you know, sometimes old systems are old systems and they no longer work for us anymore. And that's kind of how, what we're going through as a collective. I'm sure a lot of you have, experienced, I'm going to see if I can put this up higher, experienced, an old way that you used to, let's say, do things or handle things or deal with things has now changed. So what that means is if you were to, let's just say, if someone upset you, hi, Vanessa, nice to see you. If someone upset you, let's say, or was rude to you, let's say, at a grocery store, and let's say the old system or the old way of handling it, you would like yell at them, okay? Now, the new way that you do things, you can't even yell at them because you're so aware that, you know, people are going through a lot of the same thing that you're going through and maybe they're hurting as well, blah, blah, blah. So, forgive me if I'm rambling, but I'm trying to make this as simple as I can in layman's terms. So, hi. So we have these old systems, which could be the way that we run our schools. It could be the old political system that is just no longer working. Maybe even the old money system. You know, all these bitcoins is coming out, all this energy and barter trading. So there's a lot of that happening. And this all started to take a big turn in August, right? Because that's when Uranus went retrograde. That was the big solar eclipse in Leo, as well as the big eclipse before that. So we had two, I believe it was an Aquarius, okay? And Aquarius is Uranian ruled. Uranus is the only planet that spins on different than the others. There's that one and I believe Venus. So Uranus spins like cattywampus. It's like kind of crooked. And that's through experience, this energy has been different, okay, through trials. Just like Uranus, you know, maybe had been punctured by another debris, a comet or a planet, and that's why it spins funny. So wherever Uranus is in your chart, it might be affecting the changes, as well as where Aquarius is in your chart. So if you have very heavy Aquarian energy, you're probably definitely feeling this energy. Hello, Rachel. Definitely listen to the replay, but I pretty much just got started on a lot of the energy that's happening right now. So Uranus is stationary in the sky. And what that means is, as a planet with Earth, it appears to not be moving forward or backwards, because it has been moving, appears that it has been moving backwards, which the energy is just hasn't been there. Okay. So now that it's stationary, its energy is extremely heightened and intense. So when things are super strong, heightened and intense, systems shut down, or like that area of our life becomes like very like put on pause, kind of like, okay. So it will start moving forward soon. Uranus right now is at 24 degrees, 34 minutes, and it will be at 35 minutes on Friday evening, I believe. So Friday, Saturday. So that will start moving forward again. We'll feel that. We'll start feeling good. And it looks like pretty much everything should be moving direct soon. Okay. So by the time Friday rolls around, all the planets should be moving forward. So the energy is going to start feeling a little better. However, we have a lot of changes coming up. So let me just tell you guys like the changes for the big transits that are happening for January. We have Mercury, which is the communication planet, moving into the sign of Capricorn on around the 11th and 12th. Okay. So what that means is all this, pretty much we're going to be saying what we want and what we feel, and it's going to be very true. It's going to be truth. You know, sometimes we could speak things that kind of hide the fact that we actually mean something else, because we're protecting ourselves, right? Or not meaning what we say. So when Mercury goes into Capricorn around the 11th and 12th, we will be speaking more of our truths, okay? And it's going to be meeting up with the Sun, Saturn, which is the three-dimensional building, the reality, as well as Pluto and Black Moon Lilith. Wow. So there's going to be a stellium of energy, and that's going to be pretty intense. So I'd say mid-January, towards the end of the January will be pretty intense energies. Then the Sun will be moving into Aquarius around the 21st, 22nd of the month. So things will start feeling a lot lighter, let's just say, because it gives you kind of a picture or a flash of what the spring is going to look like, because that energy is pretty fun, in my opinion. Venus will be moving into the sign of Aquarius as well, around Friday the 19th, 20th. And then Mars will be moving into the sign of Sagittarius, out of the transformation sign of Scorpio, which what all the masculine energy has been feeling, will be moving out on the 27th of this month. So that will be, I believe that will be a good wrap up of all this crazy energy. And that's why I was saying to everyone, just wait until the end of January, around the 27th, the energy is going to start picking up and we're going to start feeling better. But that's all the major transits, and I will be doing videos on each one of them and breaking it down in detail as we get closer. I'm like super tired today, super out of it, but I really wanted to talk about the energy that's been going on. So there are old systems and old beliefs that are breaking apart. They're falling away from our sides, right? Because we're evolving and we're moving along with the energy of our system, our little inner galaxy that we have going on here. I feel that if there are people in your life that aren't supposed to be there, then they'll be removed and you will be, you will notice, and see things that maybe you didn't notice or see before. So there's a lot of, endings and new beginnings coming up soon because we have some eclipses that are going to start happening. You know what? Where did I put my notepad? Oh, there it is. All right. So as far as eclipses, we have one this month, a lunar eclipse in Leo at 11 degrees. So that's going to be a huge portal. I believe because we're in an 11 year, and that's a pretty, in numerology, that's a pretty awesome number. And we have a full, okay, so we have the full moon in Cancer, which is all about home, right? And what we consider to be home. And then January 16th will be the new moon in Capricorn, which is its opposite. That is pretty big, especially if your birthday is on the 16th, Matt Milius. So anyone's birthday that is on January 16th will be affected big time. It'll be the new beginning, right? It's a whole, there was a completion and now there's this new beginning that's happening. This, because Capricorn is Saturn is in its home of Capricorn, this new moon will kind of feel more like the new year than the New Year's Eve felt the new year, right? Which was yesterday or the day. Yeah, yesterday was the first. So January 16th is the new moon in Capricorn. That's pretty much the reset of the reality, you know, in the three-dimensional. Then I will talk a little more about the eclipses when we get there, but are you guys feeling tired? Are you guys body achy? How are you guys feeling? I took a bath for like an hour and a half. I actually wish I had a snorkel so I can just stay underwater longer. Just holding my breath and just like relaxing in there. It felt so good. Then I gave myself my own massage. Oh yeah. See, I wish I would have been able to sleep all day today, but I had to clean and I was like, okay, I'm back to work after 5 days off. And it was the day when like, I was just so slow. I felt like it's like grabbing all my stuff, shutting the door and then realizing like, do I even have my keys? Do I have my purse? Like, why did I not check before I closed the door? So it was like, my body was like ahead of my mind. Like everything was like lagged, like jet lag. Even my 8-month-year-old took about 3 naps. Oh, I bet that was nice for you. It's good when everyone's tired, right? Hi, Sarah, sweetheart. Ah, nice to see you. Happy New Year's, everyone. So, yeah, Definitely have hit replay. Oh, and I just, okay, so here, let me just show you the chart real quick. I also just noticed that Uranus, Uranus and Chiron, which is the wounded healer, are both at 24 degrees, meaning that's a sextile. Their energies are pretty much kind of dancing with each other. So this, from the eclipses in August and everything that's happened up, because eclipses affect the energy for 6 months. So after, when the next eclipse comes in Leo at the end of this month, Teddy, would you stop itching, please? You're shaking my shit. Can you get off my, just get off. Thank you. What was I saying? Okay, so yeah. The eclipse that's coming up, the lunar eclipse that's coming up in Leo at the end of this month is going to wrap things up from the solar eclipse and all the eclipses in August that happened. So we might see that definitely in our lives. Things that are coming to a close that's happened those 6 months, and then a reopening of a new chapter. Okay. Also, politically, you might see some changes with our good old president, because he has a Pluto conjunction coming up. He was born on an eclipse. So we might see some things politically. But here we are. Here's all the energy in Capricorn. It's kind of easier to see if I point it out. So all the blue lines, those are all positive and easy flowing. So just because it's positive and easy flowing doesn't mean it's always a good thing, right? Because sometimes too much of anything is not always a good thing. The red lines are the blocks, and blocks usually teach us something. So it looks like there's the moon in Cancer, which we just had the full moon in Cancer. So all those Cancers probably felt that completion going on, or things that maybe had come to light that they didn't know. And that is also affecting this Uranus energy. Depending on where all these are in your chart, you can find out how you're really, you know, moving forward and healing and stuff like that. Here's another square to Pluto, which is transformation and healing. And then you have Pluto opposing the moon and Cancer. So your internal mind is now healing a lot of the old structures that we have built in our life. So maybe like old karmic stuff, old maybe childhood traumas or childhood stuff that has always been a part of our paradigm for so long, you're starting to see the illusions and the delusions that's not a reality, and it's not a reality that you want to continue replaying over and over and over, and you want to make those changes. So it's like healing from your thoughts, because our thoughts create our reality. And that's a little bit of that. So here's our relationships. This is the time right now. It's kind of, I think, changing. So this is tonight at this time. Because the ascendant always changes throughout the day. It's like the clock. I mean, this is why we made clocks. Yeah. Like this. It ticks and it ticks and it turns and it turns. So here's Mars and Jupiter, which is expanding that energy. So when this becomes 17, which will probably be within the next couple days,
It's going to be super intense for the masculine energy. You guys feel it now, but it's going to like heighten and maybe you'll come to a head with everything. And then once Mars finally passes Jupiter, then you'll feel some relief and some, I'm so glad that I got through that. Do things that make you feel good. Take baths. If you're tired, take a nap. That's that. Because we all have the masculine energy. We're healing from that masculine energy, the old shit, and we're moving forward with that. That's also in relationships right now, so because it's in the seventh house at this moment right now. Sex, taxes, deaths, all of that is here in this energy. So we just got to ground. We got to think about, you know, what are we seeing? What are we smelling? What are we tasting? What are we feeling? Is our skin dry? Put some lotion on it. If you're hungry, eat. If you're thirsty, drink. If you're tired, close your eyes. If you want shit to smell good, light a candle, burn some essential oils. If you want to take a bath because your body hurts, it's all the physical. These are the things that's going to get you through this energy. You want to go here. This is where we're moving away from right now. If you're horny, have sex. Just as long as it doesn't create more drama for you in your life. make sure to be honest and clear with what you want. And make sure that it's clear with whoever you're dancing with. Mm-hmm. So the moon will be at crucial degrees. This home type stuff, pretty much while we're sleeping. I believe tomorrow the moon will finally move into Leo. And then we can start taking action again and maybe being creative and being energetic and more romantic and not so womp, 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 like a wet blanket. Okay, dokay. Does anyone have any questions? Lilith does? What? Are you in heat? Yeah? What? Lilith, what do you want, honey? What? Well, you can't because you're an indoor cat. Okay? Sorry. All right, guys. I am going to sign out if no one wants to chat because I'm not going to sit here and talk to myself. Meow, meow. Meow, meow. All right, well, I hope you guys feel better and rest and take care of yourself. All right, love you guys. Peace out.